It is our religious greeting, which means that peace and blessings of God be upon you all. The announcement of the call to pray, that was our call to pray that you just heard this gentleman read out. It sounded at least 5 times today in our faith. As Muslims, we pray 5 times today. And to announce the plea, someone is asked to actually make a physical call, and that was the call to pray. And it caught us just at the time of the week, just slightly after actually we began to perform our prayers. And please would like me to witness what we are about to do, so you can experience and see that as well. We don't have an alarm clock here. After the prayer, there will be a short presentation by one of our members. And after that, we will be having lunch before we serve it at the back. So with that said, let me welcome all of you. We're so happy that you've come. For you to come and share this with us, and also Pastor had some other experiences before coming here. A mosque, we can say, is an open house. It is not the exclusive domain of only Muslims. The Holy Prophet of Islam, the peace and blessings of God upon him, has historically documented that he welcomed people of all faiths to his house of worship. So, welcome once again. Please feel free to ask any of our members here about anything that you want to know more about. There will also be literature for you to help yourself with. So, we invite you to perform our prayer and have a seat. And those of you who want to join in this, welcome. Otherwise, you can just sit and observe.
Email the slides through to you, but you should have a copy of my presentation. It was going to be a formal PowerPoint presentation, but in the interest of time, I have decided rather than to just give you a quick overview of the slides and its content. The Ahmadiyya Muslim Jamaat is a community within the field of Islam. We have 73 different sects or divisions, or any other term you may want to use. Some of them you might be familiar with: Sunni Islam, Shia Islam, Wahhabi Islam, etc. And we are obviously from the Ahmadiyya Muslim Jamaat. Now, the Ahmadiyya Muslim community was established in 1889, exactly 128 years ago. And I could basically summarize in less than 5 minutes what this community had actually done, what they had achieved. And that in itself is a tall order. So I thought we would just focus on a few of the key issues. Because for me, one of the challenges of measuring any group is to see what sort of effect it has in the broader community, what has it actually achieved. And I thought I would just focus on some of the key achievements what this community has done. This community was founded by Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad alayhi salatu wasalam, may peace be upon him, in 1889, as I have said. And one of the first revelations vouchsafed to him was that I will cause my message to reach the corners of the earth. Today we are congregated in this particular mosque in Cape Town, which in our understanding is the small fulfillment of that prophecy, that he will cause this message to reach the corners of the earth. We are on the southern strip of Africa. And today we are witness to that particular prophecy being fulfilled. The community is established in 210 countries throughout the world. So officially we have members in more countries than the International Olympic Committee or FIFA, for example. And this community has tens of millions of adherents, besides the challenges that we have faced over the years in terms of persecution, etc. Founded in India, and obviously because of the partition, the headquarters was originally in Pakistan, where obviously our Jamaat was still being persecuted, and our spiritual head had to migrate from Pakistan to the current headquarters being in London, in the UK. So, what has this community actually done over the years? I think if I just touch on a few of them. Number one, we have a 24-hour satellite TV channel called Muslim Television Ahmadiyya, MTA. It has just celebrated its 25th anniversary. And MTA is available on all different platforms. You can get it live on the internet. You can actually stream it on your mobile. It's available on Apple and Android. And it's obviously available on our satellite TV, which we'll show you during the course of our session. And this particular broadcast is broadcast on three different channels, and it actually focuses on all different languages designed to teach, uplift, and as a means of spreading our message throughout the corners of the earth. So MTA is certainly a flagship of our community. The second one, obviously, is the Humanity First, serving humanity. And Humanity First is an organization that operates. And one of the key drivers of Humanity First is that more than 90% of all the money that we receive is used for service delivery. Now, I get to actually find an organization where they spend more than 90% of the income on actual service delivery. That in itself is an important key point to understand about Humanity First. So we are involved in all kinds of natural disasters, disaster relief, even the most latest hurricane that we had in the USA. The situation in Rohingya, in Myanmar, we're involved in every single one of these natural disasters and humanitarian issues that we have to deal with. We are also in the process of setting up our own Humanity First team in South Africa and in Cape Town as well. So at the moment we are at over 43 different countries in which Humanity First is registered. If you look at some of the achievements of this particular community, the first Muslim to have won a Nobel Prize for physics happened to be an Ahmadi Muslim. The only person in history to have been president of the World Court of Justice and president of the international organization in Den Haag was also an Ahmadi, happened to be Sir Zafarullah Khan. As a matter of fact, this year in the Oscar Awards, the best supporting actor was also an Ahmadi. So our community have achieved numerous successes over the years. We've translated the Holy Quran in over 70 languages at the back of the mosque. There's a selection of the Holy Qurans in different languages. I have a PowerPoint presentation running at the back, which gives you a snapshot of some of the achievements that we have done over the years. So, as I said, because of limited time, I cannot do justice to every single aspect of it. Suffice to say that currently we have the leader of our community, Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmed in London. Every Friday he broadcasts the Friday sermon. Now, no matter where he is in the world, it's screened live on NTA. And every single Ahmadi makes an effort to actually listen to the words and try to implement and follow the directions given to us through our Friday sermons. Every community that we have engaged from the Ahmadiyya Muslim community point of view holds an annual convention. Salama. As a matter of fact, this weekend, this coming weekend coming now, we'll have a conference in Tanzania. This weekend that just passed, we had our annual convention in Switzerland. So wherever you go in the world, you probably will find a community of Ahmadiyya Muslim Jamaat, and in some other way they are holding their conventions. So every weekend there is activities abound. So, as I said, because of time, I'm not going to go into any further detail. I think during the luncheon, we will have the opportunity to engage with members of our Jamaat. They will be at every single table. Feel free to engage with them. Feel free to ask questions. We are here to help and to guide and to portray the true teachings of Islam. I want to thank each and every one of you for taking the opportunity to come out and visit our mosque. This is an open mosque in the sense that we, as long as you worship one God, you're more than welcome to engage with us here. We have adherents of all different faiths that participate in our activities. We are a strong interfaith supporter and we encourage people to come and actually experience what a true Muslim actually believes, etc. With that few words, I'm not going to take any more time. I'm sure you're all hungry and waiting for your special lunches. So whatever I'm going to say, I'm not going to focus too much in here. So I also want to conclude and say thank you for taking the time and meeting with us. Thank you. So we will now break for our lunch, and the main venue is just follow down the road. Let's go to the men's side, and then a separate venue for the ladies' side. There should be sufficient accommodation for all of you to enjoy your lunch. I know you have a stack program because you have after this you have to go to the ashram. So we are running a little late, so please we can't squeeze in. Thank you. But we will have our members escort you with you. Thank you.
Yeah.